four earlier civilizations. And if you would have seen it, or if you read it out, you can see that all the four civilizations, they flourished on the banks of the rivers. Now let us see that what were the reasons why the earlier civilizations, they came up on the banks of the river. Now the first reason is that the rivers, they provided sufficient water or abundant water, and the water, it was very, very useful both for agriculture also and supporting the population also. So one, the first reason why the earlier civilization came up on the banks of the river is that the rivers, they provided abundant water. Okay, now the second reason is what? That the land which was near the river, it was very, very fertile. When it was fertile, it was very suitable for agriculture. The third reason is that in the olden days, since we did not have very developed roads and all, so the rivers, they were also a means of transport and communication. And the fourth reason, that the area near the river valleys, they did not suffer from extremes of climate. And so the weather or the climate, it was also warm and pleasant. So just now we have read about the four reasons why the earlier civilization flourished on the banks of the river. First is abundant supply of water. Second is extremely fertile land. Third is rivers also were a means of transport and communication. And the last one is that the weather or the climate, it was warm and pleasant. So these were the four reasons why the earlier civilization flourished on the banks of river, on the banks of the rivers. Yeah, it has been taken from Greek language. Now it is made up of two words. The first word is mesos, which means middle. And the second word is potamos, it means river. So in short, we can say that Mesopotamia, it means the land between the rivers. Okay, so the word Mesopotamia, it has been made by two words. Okay, the first word is mesos, which means middle, and the second word is potamos, which means river. So in short, Mesopotamia, it means the land between the two rivers. Now you see, we are studying about the Mesopotamian civilization, which is among one of the earliest civilizations. And the Mesopotamian civilization, it is very, very famous, okay, famous all over the world for its prosperity, for its cities, its literature, mathematics, and science. Okay, now as we know that the ancient cities and the towns of Mesopotamians, they were discovered by the archaeologists about 150 years ago. So now, children, I would like to remind you one more thing, that whenever I'm explaining the chapter, hold a pencil in hand, because you see, in the exam we are having a separate question on the dates. So wherever we are having the dates, you have to underline the date. Even in the exam also, the dates will be written and you have to mention the event which is associated with it. For example, you see, now we are about to start our third topic of the chapter, and that is the extent of the civilization. So in this, wherever we are having the date, you have to underline the date and you have to write the related event. But one thing is there, that these separately I won't make you do. So wherever, whatever date we are writing and mentioning the event, that you have to write it in your copies, because it will be easier for you to learn. You don't need to search the dates on each and every page. So it's very important that you write the date and the related events in your copies. Okay, so now we start on with the third topic of the chapter, and that is the extent of the civilization. Extent means the spread of the civilization, which were the areas in which it was spread. Okay, now you see Mesopotamia. It is located in Western Asia. Okay, Mesopotamia, it is located in Western Asia, and this is the in this modern age, the area of modern Iraq and a part of Iran is the place where Mesopotamia was located. Over. Now you see, now as I already told you about the date, so please write, underline the date, and it is 4000 BCE to 3500 CE. So please underline the date 4000 BCE to 3500 BCE. Okay. Then what event you have to write? Only you have to write Mesopotamian civilization flourished during this period. Okay, understood? You will have to write the date and then mention the event that the Mesopotamian civilization flourished during this period. That's all. Okay. Now, as I already told you earlier also, that Mesopotamia means the land between the rivers. Which were the two rivers which were in between the which this Mesopotamia it was located? They were the two rivers. They were Tigris and the other was Euphrates. Okay, so which were the two rivers? Tigris and Euphrates. As I already mentioned, since Mesopotamia, it was an area which was located in between these two rivers, they brought a large amount of water to this area. And as a result of the water, it also made the land very, very fertile. So the land became fertile and there was a regular supply of water. Now you see, these two rivers, they were regularly flooded. In the rainy season, they were regularly flooded. So in order to stop the destruction, the Mesopotamians, what did they do? They built the canals. Canals, they were very, very important to the Mesopotamians. Why they were important? First of all, they helped in irrigation. Okay, the water, it helped in irrigation. Secondly, it also helped in navigation. Navigation means it provided a passage for the ships and the boats. So, and other than this, it was also a means of transportation of the goods. Okay, the things they were taken from one place to another. So, now let us see which were the other areas which were located around this civilization. Now, southernmost region of this civilization, it was known as Sumer. Okay, the southern area of this region, it was known as Sumer. And the people, those who lived in this region, they were known as Sumerians. In the same way, in the northwestern part of Sumer, the regions, they were known as, two regions were there. There was Akkad. And the other was Babylonia. Okay. Akkad and Babylonia. Other than this, in the highland in the north, we were having an area which was known as Assyria. Okay. So, this was the extent of the civilization. Now, let us see that which are the sources which help us to know about this civilization. Now, if we see the sources, they are the next topic of the chapter. Now, if we like the two sources which are very, very helpful to us in order to know about the civilization, they were archaeological sources and the other were the literary sources. Among the archaeological sources, we are having the ziggurats. Ziggurats, they were the Mesopotamian temples, okay? And in the literary sources, we are having like the Epic of Gilgamesh. These sources, they give us a wide information about the Mesopotamian civilization. So how many sources are we having? We are having two sources, the archaeological sources and the literary sources.